Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm going over the forehead. We've talked about it before, but every time I travel or we're teaching, it comes up. And remember, it's the number two call back to your clinic is doing Botox or Disport in the forehead. And the number one is often lip filler, lip irregularity due to the motor movement. Let's go over the forehead injections. And I'm gonna go through some anatomy here today of somebody who moves a little more on one side than the other. And this often presents a problem when people are trying to use a cookie cutter way to inject Disport or Botox in the forehead. So we're gonna do forehead Disport today. Now, if the patient looks straight ahead, I'm gonna tilt you a little bit this way. This eyebrow, and when I did the assessment and talked to her, I also watched it, on her right side tends to want to lift a little bit more, and statically it sits higher. Every line tells a story. If we look at the lines on the forehead, we see there's some lines here, and she's smoother on her left. Raise for me now. There's a little more movement here on the patient's right, a little less on the left. So if we were to just do the same dose all the way through, it would be a bit erroneous because she will then have still more movement on this side. Now just relax for a minute. Statically, the muscle moves and the frontalis divides separately on everyone, but it comes up like this, okay? And it divides here. Sometimes it divides much higher up to where we have to treat the center. The point is, the only thing that the forehead muscle does is lift. So when we treat it, the only thing that can happen is it falls. Even if we do a lateral brow lift here, that will lift the lateral depending on the orbicularis oculi muscle strength. But this is the area the patients are going to come back and say, I still have movement, or you missed the spot. So the forehead, we have to counsel the patient. Now when we inject here, of course you're going to do a little more dose on this side. That's going to bring the brow down a little bit relative to her left, which is okay. That gets us towards symmetry. And remember, symmetry, we make patients more symmetrical each time, but it's not the most important part of beauty. But we do try and create it, because towards symmetry is a desirable effect. Now, let's start the injections, and we're using Disport. I use a 2cc concentration, and you can get even more longevity. So if you want to go up in strength, you can actually use a 1cc concentration, and then you get less spread of effect. Spread of effect is, for the most part, due to the concentrations that we use in the dosing. So raise for me and relax, and we're going to come right in here. And we're gonna do a few units and a few units above. Okay, now raise for me again. If we didn't do anything up in this region, she'd come back. So you can follow me along here. We'll do a little bit above. Okay, now raise again for me. On her, she probably divides centrally. So we'll treat this area. And again, I'm doing kind of a diffuse dose, because the forehead has some surface area to it. Now when we come over to the region, I'm always cleaning, as you notice, cleanliness is very important. When we come over to the region on the left, I raise for me again. Again, looking at the anatomy, and we're gonna use less of a dose on this side, because we don't want this side to fall relative. And raise again for me, and relax. And you can see, every time you ask them to raise, there's a different amount of muscular movement, and that's normal. Now, we did more here, less here, and we did treat the center. I need to see her back at 2 weeks to get this perfect. There's probably a 75% chance it's perfect. There's a 25% chance that she needs a touch-up. This is totally normal for the forehead. So when people call back, say, you missed a spot, I need more on one side than the other, the forehead is so particular, and because the brow shape is changed, that's why you'll get a callback. The people are very attuned to their forehead, and most particularly now their brows. So we used to, back in the day, see everyone back at 2 weeks, and I'd like that. Nowadays, we're in an Amazon society and world, everything's 2 days, and you can return it, but people don't want to come back and have to do anything for it. And in that case, people don't want to come back in 2 weeks, so we don't regularly do it. But it's a very normal call. Don't be discouraged by it. Get to know the patients, and this will atrophy. So each time you do it, if they come in every 3 to 4 months, that callback or return of the patient gets less and less. So that's the forehead disport. If you have any questions, ask below on this YouTube channel. Join us on Instagram and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.